Welcome to the Poor Man's Gourmet Kitchen, where we share gourmet recipes at a low-budget wonder. Now check this out.
Here I've got several bones that have been cut both sideways and lengthwise. It's not necessary, but if you feel like you want to clean them up a little bit more than how they were cleaned when you purchased them from your butcher, you want to use a dull knife and just hack down the sides until you get pieces like this. It really makes them look a lot prettier, and it's better if you're having guests. And you could do the exact same thing to the other bones as well. There's really nothing to it, just a little bit tedious is all. As you can see here, quite a bit is removed after cleaning all of those bones. But you can save these scraps for beef bone broth, which I'll be showing you how to make next video recipe. So be sure to tune in for that as well. Now the next thing you want to do is just take some regular tap water and mix in some salt. And you want to make sure that you're using enough to completely submerge the bones. And this brine will help clean the bones even further. All you have to do is get them covered and refrigerate them overnight. In the meantime, you want to chop some green onion, some flat leaf parsley, cut a fresh lemon or lime, whichever you prefer. And then in a bowl here, I've got some olive oil. I'm going to go ahead and squeeze the citrus right in there. Now what we're doing here is making a base, kind of like a topping for a tomato and basil or a roasted pepper bruschetta. And whisking these two together is real important. You want to make sure you combine it until it turns real saucy and milky like this. Then you want to add the green onion and parsley. And I like to add some chopped garlic as well. A little salt and pepper wouldn't hurt, but I like to use this fish sauce instead. And this salad topping is something you want to put together the day, not the night before you roast your bones. And now it's time to pull those out of the fridge. As you can see, that salt water has extracted a lot of the blood from the bones, and you can just pour that right out. And if you take a good look here, you can see how clean these bones actually get with that solution. It's pretty remarkable. And if I can dig down here to the horizontal cuts, I'll show you how clean these bones got. And check out this marrow. It's almost like the whole thing is just bleached. So don't forget this trade secret. Now outside, I've got the grill all heated up with a cast iron skillet. And with the long bones, you want to put them bone side down with no flipping during this cooking process. You don't want to lose that marrow to the flames. Now in the skillet, you want to go ahead and just drop in all those horizontal cuts. And if you'd like, it's a good time to go ahead and salt and pepper over the top of all of these as well. And over medium heat, you want to drop that lid and cook for 20 to 25 minutes. Now here I've got a French baguette. Roasted bone marrow is a lot like butter, so you want to cut several slices of these that you can toast. I also like to take the seasoned olive oil out of the bottom of that salad topping and drizzle that right over the bread. An alternative to this topping is chimichurri, and I'll post my recipe for that as well. Now just lay the bread slices face down on your grill right before you're ready to pull the bones. As you can see, these bones are ready. Tell me that doesn't look good, huh? If you like this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. Now these should be ready too. Yeah, we'll just get everything off the grill. Thank you. by now the bread will be perfectly toasted as well. Now straight off the grill, these are really hot, so you want to wait a few minutes and let them cool down before you serve. But check out the squish in this marrow. It's exactly the way you want it. The butter of the gods, they say. And let me show you just how tender this roasted bone marrow is. It's very gelatinous and just perfect for a spread. So if you've never tried this before and you're nervous about doing so, don't be. There's really nothing to it. You're going to surprise yourself just how good this really tastes. But just so you know, this is usually served with a shot of whiskey. And there you have it. Roasted bone marrow, right here in the Poor Man's Gourmet Kitchen.
Thank you for watching, and be sure to stop by PoorMansGourmetKitchen.com for more recipes and exact ingredients.